So the last video that I wore a swimsuit in, I got a lot of compliments on my swimsuit. So I wanted to see what you guys thought of this one. Yes, it's fall and I'm still talking about sunscreen because it's important to protect your skin year round. Sunscreen can really differ in price. A roundup of Amazon's most popular range from about 68 cents to more than 23 bucks an ounce, with the median price being around $3. If you wear sunscreen daily, like I do, that can really add up. The American Academy of Dermatology recommends a person use 1 ounce to cover their entire body and reapply every 2 hours. So let's say you're outdoors for 8 hours a week, then weekly you're applying 4 ounces. If you do that all summer, you'll spend anywhere from $38 to $1,300 over 3.5 months to cover your entire body. At first I was like, no one pays $1,000 for 14 weeks worth of sunscreen, but then I saw this. If you're using it for more than just your face, you might be surprised. And if you're buying for your whole family, it costs even more, which makes the cost a pretty important consideration. But are the pricier high-end sunscreen brands better than budget brands? Sunscreens are regulated by the FDA, which requires in the past strict safety and quality tests. That means all sunscreens of a given SPF, say 30, must provide exactly the same sun protection. So they all work the same, at least in theory. Consumer Reports released their 2018 report on sunscreen, and of the 73 lotions, sprays, sticks, and lip balms rated, they found 24 tested at less than half their labeled SPF number. Another key thing the Consumer Reports rating guide pointed out is that a sunscreen's price did not correlate with sunscreen performance. Of the 13 sunscreens Consumer Reports recommended, 12 were cost-effective brands like Coppertone, Bullfrog, Aveeno, and Equate from Walmart. What makes the high-end sunscreens more costly? Well, there's a number of reasons. Sometimes it's just a matter of positioning the price for a specific clientele that's willing to pay more. This sometimes has the unintended consequence of people using less sunscreen to make it last longer. If you're using 25 to 50% of the recommended amount, your SPF of 50 may only provide the protection of an SPF 15. Another thing you may pay extra for is look and feel. One of the biggest complaints about sunscreen is that it feels greasy, and it's pretty important to like the feel and smell, because if you don't like it, you're probably not gonna wear a lot of it. A lot of people are surprised that even non-fragrant sunscreen can have a slight plasticky scent, and for many, that's just a deal breaker. Most people prefer a dry or velvety touch to their sunscreen. Sometimes cosmetic manufacturers use cheaper ingredients like starches to get this effect, and sometimes they'll add silicas, nylons, and methacrylates, which tend to be a bit more expensive. Sometimes the added cost can come from extra features such as water resistance, and sometimes it can come from manufacturer inefficiency. Some cosmetic companies are just better at making sunscreen than others are. I guess it just goes to show that expensive products aren't always the most effective. But I'd love to hear what you guys think. Are your favorite sunscreens high-end or are they budget brands? And a special thanks to Michael Sanchez, who asked the question that inspired this episode and got me to wear this fun swimsuit.